All right, so President Trump responded to the first-class treatment by Prime Minister Theresa May by saying not the best things about her leadership. So when asked about this at a presser with the Prime Minister today, instead of owning his words, he went to his signature move.
Fortunately, we tend to record stories now, so we have it for your enjoyment if you'd like it. But we record when we deal with reporters. It's called fake news.
Remember that? He's talking about The Sun, which is run by his friend Rupert Murdoch. Remember, no one's safe when they're unflattering to Trump. Now, he also said in the piece, you know, a poll just came out that I am the most popular person in the history of the Republican Party. 92% beating Lincoln. I beat our honest Abe. They didn't have polling when Abe Lincoln was president, and most GOPers were equal or better to Trump at this point in their presidency. And he exaggerated his own polling with GOPers by 4 points. So that's all truth abuse. False. Fake. But there's a bigger challenge here. Either Trump was taken out of context, as he suggests, or, and there were a lot of nice things said, that were hidden or not. And here's the good part. Here's the challenge. We can know the answer. The Sun says they have tapes. They put out about 8 minutes or so of a roughly 30-minute interview. We can't find the rest, but they say they have them. They must be like the Sun and shine the light on everything said. And if they can't, Trump said, you just heard him, that he has tapes too. He told reporters, you can get it from Sarah. Get it from Sarah, Sarah Sanders, right? He has suggested this before, that they have tapes and not produce them. We have been told that the traveling pool did ask for that audio more than 8 hours ago. No sign yet that the White House is going to give them up. So, it's either a big deal or it isn't. Now, I know people are going to say, everyone lies in politics. No, the truth matters, especially now. And someone lying a lot doesn't make their lying less of a lie. We should not apply a different standard to our president than we do to our kids. Can you imagine letting your 8-year-old get away with lying about doing her homework? I have one at home. This is a very factual scenario. No, we wouldn't do it. But it's okay when a president calls out the media and attacks any who try to call him out on a world stage? No, it isn't. Produce the tape, son, please. If not, Sarah, get after it, all right? Make the truth known. This is a put up or shut up moment.